Hello and welcome to Rao's IAS. This is the daily prelims practice initiative wherein we discuss important MCQs from the Hindu and Indian Express. The topics for today's discussion are mentioned over your screen. So let's begin our session.
So the first MCQ for today is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 3 of the Hindu. Recently, the Supreme Court of India has said that the governors of state should return the bills as soon as possible to the state legislative assemblies and they should not sit over the bills, making state legislative assemblies wait indefinitely. So as we know that the powers related to the office of governor is important for our UPSC examination. In the year 2018, we found this particular question which was regarding the same. On the similar lines, we have framed our first practice question which states that, consider the following statements. So the first statement is, if a money bill which is passed by the state legislature is reserved by the governor for the consideration of the president. The president may direct the governor to return the bill to the house. Now this is an incorrect statement. Let us see why. Now as per Article 201 of Indian Constitution, when the governor of any state reserves any bill for the consideration of the president of India, then the Indian president has three options. Either to give assent to that bill, to withhold his assent to the bill, or he can direct the governor of the state to return the bill to the House of State Legislature. But in the case of money bill, there is an exception. In the case of money bill, the president can either give assent to the bill or he can withhold the assent. But he cannot direct the governor to return the bill to the House. So that's why our first statement is incorrect. Second statement, as per the Constitution, governor must reserve the bill passed by the state legislature if it contains the provision which endanger position of the state high court. So this is a correct statement. So as per Article 200 of Indian Constitution, the governor shall not give assent and must reserve any bill passed by the state legislature which contains provisions that endanger the position of state high court or would derogate from the powers of high court. Also, the Article 200 of Indian Constitution mandates that the governor should, as soon as possible, return the bill other than money bill for reconsideration by the House. So the correct answer to this MCQ is option B, that is 2 only. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option C. So the next question for today is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 13 of The Hindu. So as per this news article, the central government has aimed to integrate Vibrant Villages Plan with PM Gati Shakti Mega Project. So this article is important under various scheme by the Union Government. In the year 2017, we found a question on this government scheme, Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. Now let us solve our practice question which states that, with reference to the Vibrant Village Program, consider the following statements. Statement 1. The program focuses on inclusive development of villages across the northeastern states of India. Now this is an incorrect statement. This is because Vibrant Village Program was announced in the financial year 22-23 with an aim to develop infrastructure and open up villages across the China border. So this scheme aims to develop essential infrastructure and livelihood opportunities in 4 Indian states and 1 Union Territory. These are the northern states which border China. They include Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, and Arunachal Pradesh, and it includes 1 Union Territory of Ladakh. So by creation of essential infrastructure like all-weather road, 24/7 electricity, drinking water supply and sanitation facilities, and livelihood opportunities like promoting the tourism sector will help develop infrastructure in these border villages and would also help in encouraging the people to stay in their native locations in border areas and thus reversing out-migration. And this will add to the increased security of the border. The second statement is, the program would function as a centrally sponsored scheme under the Ministry of Home Affairs. Now this is a correct statement. The third statement is, Vibrant Village Action Plans will be created by the state administration after consultation with the Gram Panchayats. Now this is an incorrect statement. This is because the action plans for the development of these villages will be created by the district administration and not by the state administration. And this would be done after the consultation with the Gram Panchayats. So the correct answer to this practice MCQ is option B, that is 2 only. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option B. The next practice question for today is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 14 of The Hindu. Now, as per this article, malaria is all set to become a notifiable disease across India. We all know that malaria is a life-threatening mosquito-borne disease which is spread by the bite of female Anopheles mosquito. India has a vision to be malaria-free by the year 2027 and to eliminate the disease by the year 2030. As we all know that UPSC has asked questions regarding various diseases. In the year 2014, we saw this particular question. Now let us solve our practice question which states that consider the following statements with reference to the notifiable disease. Statement 1. The onus of notifying any disease and the implementation lies with the central government. Now this is an incorrect statement. This is because health is a state subject in India. So it is the responsibility of the state governments to notify any disease and its implementation will lie with the state government. So let us understand what is a notifiable disease. So generally, any high infectious disease is made a notifiable disease in India to control the spread of such disease. So when any disease is set as a notifiable disease, it is required or mandated by the law to report the incidence of these disease to the government authorities. And this collection of information will allow the government authorities to monitor the disease, provide early warning of possible outbreak, and formulate a plan for their elimination. Hence, the state government declares notifiable disease and the central government maintains the list of these diseases. Second statement says, any failure to report a notifiable disease to government authorities is a criminal offense. Now, this is a correct statement. So, when any disease is declared as a notifiable disease, every government hospital, private hospital, laboratories and clinics will have to report the cases of the disease to the local government authorities, that is to the chief medical officers. And any such failure to report the disease will be a criminal offense. And the state government can take necessary actions against the defaulters. So as of now, these are the notifiable diseases in India, which include cholera, diphtheria, encephalitis, leprosy, meningitis, whooping cough, plague, tuberculosis, AIDS, hepatitis, measles, yellow fever, malaria and dengue. So the correct answer to this question is option B, that is 2 only. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option B. So the next MCQ for today is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 15 of Indian Express. So recently, the report of first water census which was conducted in the year 2018-2019 was released. Now this news article is important under various surveys, report and schemes of Government of India. In the year 2018, we found this question on a survey by NSSO. Now let us solve our practice question which states that consider the following statements with reference to the water bodies first census report. Statement 1. Water bodies first census report has been published by the Niti Aayog. Now this is an incorrect statement as the survey was conducted by the Ministry of Jal Shakti. Second statement. The report has surveyed only the natural water bodies in the country. Now this is also an incorrect statement. Let us see why. So the first water census in India has found more than 2.4 million water bodies in India. And for the purpose of the census, the water bodies included all natural and man-made units of water storage, which were bounded on all sides with some or no masonry work. That is, these are the bounded water bodies, like ponds, tanks, lakes and reservoirs. So these water bodies do not include running water bodies like rivers, streams, oceans, lagoons. The third statement is Jharkhand, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, West Bengal and Gujarat are the top 5 states wherein the major use of water bodies is in irrigation. Now this is a correct statement. Now let us see the major findings of this report. Out of 2.4 million water bodies, the maximum water bodies are in West Bengal. So around 60% of these water bodies are ponds, followed by tanks and reservoirs. The maximum numbers of ponds and reservoirs are in West Bengal, tanks in Andhra Pradesh, lakes in Tamil Nadu, and water conservation schemes in Maharashtra. So the correct answer to this MCQ is option B, that is 3 only. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option C. Our next practice question is based on this particular article which appeared on the page number 17 of Indian Express. As per this article, NARCL, which is National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited, has aggregated or acquired stressed loans of Rs. 21,000 crores till March 2023. Now this topic is important under Indian economy and issues related to planning and mobilization of resources. In the year 2017, we found this particular question based on similar theme. Now let us solve our practice question, which states that consider the following statements with respect to National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited, NARCL. Statement 1. Public sector banks hold majority stake in NARCL. This is a correct statement. Now let us see what is NARCL. So NARCL is an asset reconstruction company which was set up by banks in the year 2021. So what is the function of NARCL? It acquires or consolidates the stressed assets of commercial banks and financial institutions. So in layman terms, we can say that NARCL buys bad loans from banks, and the public sector banks have 51% stake or majority stake in NARCL. Statement 2. NARCL acquires bad loans from the banks by paying the entire amount in security receipts. Now this is an incorrect statement. Now this is because NARCL acquires stressed assets from the banks through 15% cash payment and 85% payment through security receipts. So what is security receipt? It is a kind of financial instrument that is issued by NARCL to banks in exchange of non-performing assets from these banks. And now this bank can sell these security receipts to other investors like asset reconstruction companies, alternative investment funds, or other financial institutions. And by selling these security receipts, the bank can recover some portion of their bad loans. So the correct answer to a practice question is option A, that is one only. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option B. So the final question for today is from the recently released Logistic Performance Index. UPSC in the previous years has asked questions regarding reports, index and indicators by various international institutions. As in the year 2019, we found this question on Global Competitiveness Report. Now let us solve this question, which states that Logistic Performance Index was released recently by which among the following organizations? The options are World Trade Organization, World Bank, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, and International Labour Organization. So recently, the World Bank has released Logistic Performance Index. So this index is released by World Bank every 2 years. The last such index was released in 2018, and due to COVID-19 disruptions, the latest report has been released in 2023. Now, according to this latest report, India's performance in this index has increased, and now India is ranked 38 out of 139 countries. Previously in 2018, India was ranked 44th. So this index measures the ease of establishing reliable supply chain connections, and it scores the countries on 6 key dimensions. These are infrastructure quality, ease of arranging shipments, logistics services quality, customs performance, tracking and tracing the consignments, and data measuring logistics efficiency. So the correct answer to our practice question is option B, that is World Bank. And the correct answer to our UPSC PYQ is option C. Now this brings an end to today's session. Stay connected for more updates. Thank you.